absolutely. Heroes Hat, it's a really big event, not only for myself, but for the Quinnipiac community. And, you know, this game is easy to get up for, not only for myself, but for the team. And, you know, we've been looking forward to this for a while. And the Heroes Hat, it's special around this community, especially the Quinnipiac. You know, there's a student here that actually is the Mescali family. And, you know, there's no better place to have the hat than Quinnipiac.
Oh, this game is extremely important to me. You know, playing for the Heroes Hat, take a lot of pride in that, as do the rest of the guys, and it's big for our community, big for our school, and we're looking to get the hat back.
Live from the TD Bank Sports Center in Hamden, Connecticut, it's Quinnipiac University Hockey on SNY. Bobcats take on the Bulldogs of Yale tonight in a great ECAC matchup between two backyard rivals. And a very good evening, everybody. I'm Bill Schweitzer. My partner is Rich Coppola. A lot of things on the line tonight, not the least of which is the Heroes Hat. It's the fire helmet worn by New York City fireman Joe Mescali, who lost his life at the World Trade Center at 9/11. And this game, 10 years to keep that memory alive of all those people that lost their lives.
Billy mentioned 9/11 is going to bring forth a lot of emotions. The Heroes Hat game is very important to the Quinnipiac community.
And if that's not enough, it's the standings in the ECAC. They are tighter than a sardine can. Quinnipiac can finish anywhere from third place down to eighth place, and nothing in between. Yale also with a chance to jump up. There you see it, Rich. It's like an elevator.
Well, we said it before the Harvard game. We promised this could go down to the end. I think the bottom line is, sure, Quinnipiac would love to get a first-round bye. I think more importantly, they have home ice advantage at first, and they have been very good on their home ice.
Well, the players are going to get this job done. For Quinnipiac, it's the Jones twins, led by Kellen Jones. He has been a spark plug for this Quinnipiac team.
Hey, Billy, this Edmonton draft pick, he had a five-point game against Carson recently, had 4 points again last night. He's hit his stride. He's fast, he's skilled, he works well with his twin brother, as you mentioned. You know, you'll see him play the point on the power play. Coaches like the fact that he's very poised with the puck. With Langlois out, he now leads the club in goals.
Very skilled, and these two guys can really move. They're fun to watch. So keep an eye on them, the Jones brothers. For Yale, they have a lot of weapons as well, Rich, but probably their biggest weapon is Brian O'Neill. He really is a guy that gets it done for the Bulldogs.
Well, they've had some really skilled forwards the past couple of years, and he certainly fits the bill. You can't allow him time and space. Some, including Quinnipiac assistant Bill Riga, told me O'Neill is as good as any forward in the league. Now, as he's skilled, he has great speed, great on the power, Billy, and he plays with an edge. And when you have that skill and play with an edge, that's a great combination.
It is indeed. So those are the players that are going to lead the way. We've got a jam-packed building here at the TD Bank Sports Center. There's not enough seats when these two teams play each other. And right smack dab in the middle of all of that confusion, the third member of our team, Bill Mecca. Billy?
Well, I'll tell you what, I couldn't think of a better place to be. You had over 6,000 people watching a men's and women's basketball doubleheader on the other basketball venue, and today, close to 4,000 at the bank. 10,000 fans at TD Bank. I'm having a fun night. Peace.
Tell you what, Rich, better him than us. Quinnipiac and Yale, ready to go, coming up right here on NESN. All right, Connor Jones, the other Jones brother, is down with our Bill Mecca down at the Quinnipiac bench. Billy?
Hey, Connor, pretty intense first period there. Nobody scores, but give me your take on the game.
Yeah, I don't know. I think both teams are a little nervous. I think the puck was bouncing a lot in the crowd tonight. And I think that was just, we were back and forth a little, lackadaisical on defense, both teams, I think. I think second period, you expect a little bit more sound defensively hockey game for both teams.
You know, sophomore year now, leading scorer for this Quinnipiac team with 31 points. Is this a game you feel you need to put some points on the board for Quinnipiac to win?
Yeah, I feel like every night of the game I have to put some points in the net and create some offensive chances. So this is just another one to go get it.
Well, I'll tell you what, good job in the first period. We'll be watching in a second.
Quinnipiac and Yale scoreless. The women's basketball and hockey teams here at Quinnipiac winding down their seasons. For the seniors, it means unlacing their skates and their sneakers and eventually stepping into new careers.
I really started to see athletics as a great opportunity for me to have the environment where I could learn a lot of different skills that were going to help me for the rest of my life.
In terms of really what they're here for is an education first and foremost. And the education that the young ladies we recruit, they do tremendous work in the classroom.
And I don't think our young women show up here with any illusions of playing pro hockey when they're done. So I don't think we have to deal with that. But I don't think it's as much of an issue for young women as young men who might, you know, when they get here, they all are thinking they're going in that direction.
I majored in psychology. So with working with kids and, you know, having that aspect of it that, you know, it just carried over and I knew I wanted to coach.
And I think what I realized is that I did want to stay in it when I thought about, like, what would I like to do? I wanted to stay in coaching for a little while.
I think my coach did a really excellent job of helping me to see that those skills I was learning on the ice, the challenges I was tackling, those were transferable and I was going to be able to use those in my life beyond in whichever career it was I was going to tackle.
Well, we currently have a plethora of doctors, lawyers, educators, healthcare professionals.
We have like pre-med and pre-law and a few communications and some like teachers.
They're all, you know, all facets of business. We have physical therapists out there. You know, pretty much you can go down where all the majors are at Quinnipiac and you're going to find women's hockey players out there doing that.
We end up with people going into education, people going into business, insurance. It's a wide range. I don't think that there's just this one track that people go down. They really open up and have a lot of different career opportunities.
They're well prepared and ready to have that change to go out into the real world. And they're excited by that.
You know, we try and prepare them for what they're going to face when they get out of here. And that means they better be very organized, they better be, you know, confident. And we do our best to have empowered young women leave us, you know, after 4 years to engage in that battle out there.
I look at our seniors who are graduating this year and I'm so excited to see what they're going to be doing in 10 years because it's a really neat group of people and to watch them grow and to see that when they leave here, they're ready for anything. They're really ready to take on any challenge.
All right, Quinnipiac and Yale headed to the second period. No score in the game. Stay right where you are. We'll be back.
And I think if they can put pressure on their D, they're going to cough the puck up. They've done it several times tonight without being pressured.
Shot off the faceoff, but Yale clears the puck all the way down as Kellen Jones after it gets it away to Curry. Now Kellen Jones comes racing in with a head of steam and deep. Fights off a check, still has the puck. Kellen Jones out on the far side. Goes cross ice. This is Matt Pekka with the puck. Pekka to Barron. Curry to Kellen Jones. Bobcats moving the puck. Shot score! Lauren Barron with the power play goal. And the Bobcats tie the game at 1-1. Good puck movement on that by the Bobcats. And Barron bangs it home.
Well, Billy, that was how you really draw it up. They moved the puck beautifully there. Barron was in a deep slot, made the quick shot, wasted no time, and that's what you want to do. Get the puck off quickly before the goaltender really has a chance to set up. Very good movement, puck movement by the Bobcats, who tied this game on the power play. The quick pass right there to Barron in the slot, in the circle, and he made no mistake, and the Bobcats tie the game at 1-1.
Nearly midway through the second period here. Take one more look at it. There's Barron, and he got it off quickly, and he had to with the defense coming right at him. Bobcats on the power play. Pekka skates cross ice. In shot score! Kellen Jones to Connor Jones. Bing, bang, boom, and it's tied at two.
Well, you can see it developing. Once they had the two on one down low, it was just Kellen and Connor doing what they do, and they read each other so well. Really no chance for the goaltender on that time, and the Bobcats are able to tie the game at 2-2. Again, they worked the puck down low, creating a two on one down low right there. Pass across, no mistake, and the Bobcats tie it at 2-2. A great pass from Kellen to Connor.
And don't forget Pekka. Pekka with some good patience to get that play started.
Yeah, sometimes people want people to make the play so fast and not set up, and everyone wants things to happen in a hurry, but that time patience was a virtue for the Bobcats.
Still a minute. 5 minutes left in the period. Quinnipiac and Yale tied at 2-2 in the second. Quinnipiac women's lacrosse, the defending champs of the NEC, picked to win it again. Marissa Caraleo is their top player.
It's always an honor to be ranked first, you know, coming into the season, but in order to have a repeat of last year, even make it further into the NEC tournament like we hope to, we need to come out to practice every day, working hard, and, you know, execute our game plan when it comes to game time.
All right, Marissa Caraleo, the Quinnipiac women's lacrosse team, that season just getting underway. And expected in this atmosphere. All right, we have Matthew Pekka, the Bobcats forward, standing by with Bill Mecca. Billy?
Well, Matt, kind of strange period that time. You get the five-minute major, and Yale gets the goal. A lot of ebbs and flows. What was your feeling when they put the puck in the net?
It was a tough break, you know, just a little miscommunication, but it's huge to get those two goals after it, and we needed to get that back.
They got two kind of fluky goals. Seems like you guys have started to outplay them in the second. As you head to the third, what are you looking to accomplish?
Well, we're confident that we're gonna outplay them the rest of the game. We just got to keep pressure on their D, get pucks deep, get pucks on net.
Heard a lot about you, Matt. You've been playing well. Coaches told me last night, maybe the best game of your career. You're the best player on the ice. Big things from you, not expected from you. How do you handle that pressure?
I don't see it as pressure. I just use it. It's exciting. I use it as excitement, try and use that energy, and, you know, try and play my best every game.
I tell you what, he's calm and cool. Thanks for joining us, Matt. Back upstairs, fellas.
All right, thanks, Billy. Big second period. All right, Quinnipiac and Yale tied at 2-2. Good hockey game through two periods. So if you're the coach of the Quinnipiac Bobcats, what do you tell your guys in between periods? Well, let's go eavesdrop into the locker room and take a listen to what Rand Pecknold had to say.
Commit to the back check. You're coming back hard every single time, whether you need to or not. Right? Forwards, we're all going to commit to it. We're all doing it. We're going to commit to the F3. Right, get our forecheck going. We've got some nice things down low, working their D with good puck possession, a couple jam plays. We've got to commit that we have that F3, and we're all coming back. Everything we do is hard for them. Right? The 1-3 in the neutral zone on the penalty kills, excellent. Great job holding the outsides. Very, very good. One thing I want to see a little different, we disrupted that 5 wide a little bit. Let's be a little smarter. So we're Spence.
Yeah.
So you got a little low, and they zipped it up high to create that 2-on-1.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So come a little bit higher so that you can jump O'Neill or whoever they gave it to over there.
Okay.
Everybody follow me?
Right here, Yale and Quinnipiac tied at 2-2 earlier today here in this building, the final regular season game in the Men's Northeast Conference. Quinnipiac knocked off their nemesis, Robert Morris, 73-69. James Johnson, playing his final regular season game here at the bank, is with Bill Mecca. He had a heck of a day today.
Well, you sure did a heck of a day. 28 points for you today, James, on senior day. Talk about the day, the whole day, and the experience.
I just wanted to give a last impression on the fans. It's my last day, me and Kevin's last day. I just wanted to go out with a bang and against our arch rivals, against Robert Morris. That put a little icing on the cake, too.
I tell you, it was nice having the crowd. You look at the crowd here, and just thinking like 8 hours ago, 3,200 in the bank. It was set up perfect for you, but you delivered. Now, it's hard to deliver on a big day. You delivered.
Yeah, I just thank the fans for coming out. They supported us early, and they supported the hockey team now. And I'm a senior, and I'm a leader, and I just got to step up in big time, and that's what I did.
Now, you got the round to the playoffs, starts on Thursday, and it's got to go through Brooklyn. And I sense you're pretty happy about going back home. St. Francis, New York, what, 7 o'clock Thursday night?
Yeah, there's no place like home, man. It's a great atmosphere, and I love playing again at home and in front of my fans and my family, so I'm just going to come out and give everything I got.
And what do you think for this Bobcat team, partner? You know, you win the first round, you got Wagner, you got LIU. Can this Quinnipiac basketball team win a championship?
If we keep defending and rebounding and getting better and just keep getting proven in practice, I think the sky's the limit for us.
Well, I tell you what, I'll be watching. Best of luck. Great game today.
Thank you.
Thanks, Billy.